Honorable Chief Guest, Mr. Langoman, Secretary of Education, Cultural Affairs, Sports and Youth Affairs, Northern Province. And our Honorable Guest of Honor, Mr. K.J. Bradley, Honorable Director, Zona Education Office, Mannar. And our special guest, Reverend Father P. Krishna, you know, Director and Liturgy Commission, Mannar. My dear teachers and dear parents and my dearest students, I really thank you very much. I thank the principal of this school for having invited me here as one of the guests here, because I'm really proud about coming here and attending this function, because I was the old boy and I am the old boy of this school, so I'm very happy that you have honored me in this way. First of all, in the meantime, you know, I was asked to give a very short speech because of the time limitation. So I guess I'll just try to say a few things. My appreciation in addition goes to all the prize winners in this participation, because it's a day of celebration and it's a day of fun, because you have achieved something. You have achieved academically and you have achieved in sports, and you have achieved in literary cultural competitions. So all these are part of education. All these are part of education. Earlier, these, apart from the academic achievements, sports, literary, cultural performance, participation were considered as extracurricular activities. But now it has been changed, and all these activities have become co-curricular activities. So in education, we have given importance to these activities as well, because it develops our soft skills. So that way, students should have a round personality, so that it gives a lot of value to their personality development. And there may be two types of students. There may be two types of students. Some students are extroverts, and some students and some people are introverts. Extroverts mean the people, they are very sociable, conversant, and they socialize with other people very friendly, and they don't have any reservations or shyness in interacting with others and new people. So those people are called extroverts. And the second category of the people are called introverts. Introverts mean the people like to be alone, and they are always reflective, and they don't want to mix up with others in functions, and they want to be cool in their own world, always reflecting. And there are two types of people. Sometimes there is an opinion that these introverts are not good for education or learning. But it is not so. I heard that the world famous scientists, Einstein and Isaac Newton, they all are introverts, not extroverts. So introverts also have their talents and potential in their brain. So they can also give something to the society. So these certificates and testimonials given on this day should be meaningful, and we should cover all the aspects of that education. So, coming back to my experience in the school, I studied here in 1980, 81 and 82 period, 3 years I studied here. At the time, yes, Brother Bastian and Brother Michael Joseph, they were here, and we studied at the time. And only 3 years I studied here. At the time, if you take our education, We don't have credit cards. We don't know anything about credit cards. And we don't know anything about ATM cards. And we know only about birthday cards. So the kind of education is similar. As our Donald Director of Education has clearly described the modern day education, I really appreciate that he has pointed out some good things here. Yeah? And we heard about hardware. If we say hardware, we know only the bolts and nuts, not the computer hardware. And even the software, we never heard of that. That word is never existed at the time. So, but as our director, Lauren's director has told, things have changed. So we also move towards that direction. That is important. After my 3-year education in the school, I went to St. Patrick's College, where I studied there for 3-4 years, and I am proud to say that I am an examiner of objects merely evaluated missions, and I studied there, and I studied in St. Patrick's College as well. Then when I entered to the Jaffna University only, I was familiar with your principal, and he was following special in geography. I was doing English literature, linguistics, and philosophy things. So, but I was not very close to him, but I know him, and I could remember I visited his residence where he stayed, and we had champion. And I assure you that even at that time, he was an extrovert. Okay, he socialized very well, and interacted with people, and did some good humors, very humorous. So very curious. So I could observe that. So the students are lucky to have him as the principal of the school here, and he is thinking differently. I could observe that. And he is trying to link the school with the community. That is a very good idea that is happening here. So I am happy here. Then my university studies are over. I was there as one year. I was there as a instructor at the university department, English language department. Then from 1995 onwards, up to now, I have been here at the Vavuniya campus of the University of Jaffna, serving the students at national level. So now I am also happy to say that Vavuniya campus of the university is going to be the University of Vavuniya very soon. So we are going to have an independent university in Vavuniya that represents the Latin region. Of course, our proposal we submitted as University of Bali, but unfortunately, the cabinet, some ministers did not like that word Bali. So we had to change that word, and we went for University of Vavuniya. And very soon, the cabinet has given approval, and we have some interventions are going on, so very soon it's going to be an independent university at University of Vavuniya. And we were born and we were bred, grown in the war time. So I was really interested in. So now we are alive. It's a lucky thing. It's a very fortunate thing we are alive. Because when we studied in Jaffna and other universities, the war was going on, and we had faced a lot of problems to become people like now. It's not that easy. In Jaffna at the time, no electricity. It was under the control of the LGB, and no power, nothing, kerosene lamp, and always bombing, shelling, and keeping brother So we try to manage our education with all the barriers there. So I want our children also to know about the value. Now they are peace. They are there's a kind of no war situation, and peace is there. So they can utilize a lot of resources to become good citizens of this country. So we cannot forget war and its impact. That's why I wrote a book, and that book called Principal has already told it. It's a Bandy Farmers in War Times. So it tells about how farmers survive. We always look at the people in Bandy during the war times as victims. So we don't need, okay, that is true. There were a lot of problems. But at the same time, we should look at it as survivors of the war. Because they survived. And they created a lot of local strategies and techniques to survive. So I have documented, in this book actually, I have documented those things. And it should be documented. That's why in future, the people will come to know what has happened. The people of Vavuniya, the farmers of Vavuniya. In my research also, in my PhD research also, focus on that ethnic conflict and international intervention. And I look at the media discourse and how they project ethnic conflict and international intervention in resolving our conflict. So that is also, again, since we were brought and lived in that war situation, I wanted to record these things and something to contribute to the society. So again, I repeat again for the students and teachers one more small point. Please listen. Sometimes people say speaking skill is better than listening skills. Listening skill is better than speaking skill. So teachers and students should listen. They should have the patience to listen. Sometimes it is extremely difficult in school education, in schools, because there are more children and there will be a lot of mischief and it's very difficult to control them. But still, we try to maintain that listening skill. That is important. So that then only we can identify the full potential of the students, and we can make use of that full potential of the students. So that's saying that every school is a good school. There is no school is a bad school. Every school is a good school. And the teachers can play a tremendous role to mold these children and become the good citizens. I know there are some certain limitations when it comes to teachers. Teachers, and we understand that the teachers are not well paid. They struggle financially. So there are some issues. But among those issues, we have to look at our welfare of our children. Children are the core, the primary focus of ours. So I wish all the best on this day, and I kindly invite our Reverend Brother Reginald. I want to donate this book to the school library. It is on this as a memorable to remember this day. So I kindly invite you. And thank you very much for listening to me.
Pray, Valentine Chandra, Visa Virendra, our Valentine Andre.